Aloha. Friends, I feel a deprivation here. I don't see your faces. Maybe it is good. Because I will be probably excited and it was difficult for me to talk to you. I remember a tablet of Abdul Baha. He said that all the prophets of the past were longing to be at this time so that they could serve Muhammad. This is a very, very powerful statement. All the prophets of the past were longing to be born in this age, to serve Baha'u'llah. I have to say, I envy you because you are young and you have an opportunity to serve a long time in Baha'u'llah and make up for the prophets of the past who have been deprived of doing it. Then, we should be very grateful to the Universal House of Justice who have provided this opportunity for the youth throughout the world in a large scale, largest ever for the youth organization to direct you, help you, guide you in the path of service. This is very, very important because this is an acknowledgement by the Universal Law of Justice of the recognition of the importance of the youth in our history, in our faith. Bob was 25 years old. Baha'u'llah was only 2 years older than him. Abdul Baha from childhood, he was serving Baha'u'llah. Shammai Effendi, the beloved guardian, remember that. Shammai Effendi, beloved guardian, was only 24 years old when for the first time, without his knowledge, in the Will and Testament of Abdul Baha, he found out that he is appointed as the guardian of the Baha'i faith. See what a great shock was in him. If you read his tablets, early tablets, writings, he always says that without my expectation, this heavy load has been taken, has been put on my feeble shoulder. You need not go back to the history and see most of the heroes of the faith have been the young people. I am not going into detail of it, and then I do not want to name them because there are so many things. And we have got to our lover, and we have got Buddy, we have got for your sake, and all of them. Now, the House of Justice has called you to rise and serve our Lord briefly before you are really enter into heavy responsibilities which life will put on your shoulder, on your shoulder. This is a very important subject. We are told to mix up the zeal and will to serve mankind along our effort to promote the faith. This combination of service and teaching is a very significant one. Abdul Baha says, worship of God is through serving mankind. And teaching the faith is one of the, I mean, probably after recognition of Baha'u'llah, is the first duty of every Baha'i, to teach the faith. What does it mean to teach the faith? Many people feel that teaching the faith means to make others Baha'is. But this is not what Baha'u'llah said. He said, I will quote, it's not exactly his word, but you are familiar with his word. He said, whatever is with you, introduce it to the people, show it to the people. If they accept it, so much the better. If not, leave them to themselves and pray for them. In other words, and also guidance and personalization is against the principles of the faith. These are very important things. When we are Baha'is, we believe in the oneness of mankind. There are a number of principles involved in it. We believe, as Abdul Baha says, that religion should be the source of love and unity. If it is a source of discord and disunity, it is better not to have religion. There are other principles. When we say that this is a universal faith of Allah, the universal faith of Allah is not all-inclusive. It doesn't mean that all Baha'i the world will become Baha'i. No, it is a part of it. But everything within the faith, we should remember that's universal. It doesn't have any bond, any diversion between people. For instance, we say you are all the leaves of one branch and fruits are bunching, or something. He said, oh, what this all means? All means Baha'i, Persian, American. It's all, not any distinction, any exception. That's why it's a universal affair. Now, the differences in the world start when the religion manifests itself in the wrong way outward your inner self. In other words, oh, he's a Baha'i, he's not a Baha'i. A Muslim said, he is not Muslim. I am going to heaven. He goes to hell. Christian, oh, he is not saved because he doesn't believe in Jesus Christ. Gave his life on the cross. This itself the beginning of differences, different of discord. Don't you remember the hidden words of Allah? He says, the most negligent among men are those who seek to advance themselves over their brothers. What does it mean? That I am better than you because I'm a Baha'i and you are not. This is not the teaching difference. Because this is exactly the same attitude which those people of the past who had caused these differences in the world at war and bloodshed started with this kind of our idea. Now, Universal House of Justice has mixed up as I said. The service to mankind with your teaching effect. But this service to mankind is because you want to serve the people in order to make them Baha'is? Is it the attitude? To me it is not. It is wrong. You serve mankind because this is the way to worship God, irrespective of what is the result. Because of course, your deed will attract people to understand the faith of the Lord, to investigate the faith, and many times they become Baha'is, there's no doubt about it. But this should not be your motive. This should not be our intention. Because that will be a hypocrisy. Remember, dear friends, young people who are now jumping to the sea of service, try to learn swimming. And I'm sure none of you will get drowned. Remember that Abdu'l-Bahá said, if you love somebody, express your love to somebody, express your service to somebody in order to teach the faith to him, this is hypocrisy. You have to love him the love of mankind should be born in us. Of course, there are differences in the world. Somebody has got blue eyes, somebody has got brown hair, or somebody is tall, or somebody is short. So there are differences. There are Baha'is and non-Baha'is and so on. But it does not mean that which is better than the other. There is one great principle in this faith. Please remember. Baha'u'llah said, all your deed, it means good deed, virtuous deed. He said, all your deed is depending on his acceptance. In other words, don't be proud at what are you doing. Because you don't know whether what are you doing is accepted by Allah or not. This is very important.